As comfortable as it is to stay in bed and scroll through our phones, flowers only blossom by growing up.
The light has to go on for people, and when it does, what are you going to do with it?
Life is all about growth, whether it's growing relationships or growing as a ball player.
Like, your level went from where I could say in grade nine, even 10, you kind of sucked. Yeah. And I've never seen anybody come from here to here as big of a jump as you. Your work ethic was, nobody was close to that. And that's why you jumped so far. And that's why you, by the time you left here, were one of the top three players in the league.
However, the most important growth is that which is done in regards to our character.
You were a very different guy in 12 plus. You went from being a silly boy to a man. It was very weird to watch. Him and I have talked about it lots of times. It's like you went, I'm done with this nonsense. And you just grew and you started to listen to people. You didn't act like a know-it-all. You would come in and you would say, you know, I don't think I would have been picked to be a captain, but they picked me. What should I do to be a good leader? Like, you were always super respectful. You'd always say hello in the halls. As a matter of fact, something you probably don't remember, I bet you don't remember this. The kids that I have the odd time will mouth me are grade nines because they don't know who I am. And I said, hey, you need to knock it off because you're going to turn a little deal into a big deal. I'm just asking you. We're down the hall. I didn't even see you. And you said, why don't you just shut up to the kid? And the kid looked at you and he just stopped. After, I said, hey, Ben, just be careful. I don't want to see you get in trouble. And you just said, well, we don't even talk to you like that. So, like, why would he think he could?
Man, I don't remember this at all.
You were down by the gym door and he was with a couple of his buddies. So he's putting on a show. I thought it was going to turn into a big deal, but you stopped it like dead in its track because he stopped as soon as you said it. Nothing. He didn't hear people out of mouth.
Yeah.
Just shut up.
The question now is, how do you develop character? And how do you take your game to the next level?
You can't beat work. Like, the kids that work, and they make it a priority. And they're like not out being goofy. They're at the gym, playing, practicing moves, practicing shots, running the floor, getting in shape. Those are the kids that progress to at least reach the peak of their ability. It's like, even though you're an elite basketball player, you got to see when you went to college and played some college ball, you saw guys that were like, holy crap.
Yeah.
In high school, I rose to the top, but the next level brought me back down to the bottom. At Georgian College, I spent most of my time coming off the bench. My only solution was plain and simple. I had to put in the work. I continued to put in the work during the next 2 years when we faced the COVID-19 pandemic. I worked and worked until the next opportunity came. And that is where the rest of this story picks up.
What's up?
Oh my goodness.
And the other notch of five little swirls? Okay. So then open the blue, stick the swab in inside
this way.
Yep. Put it all the way down, keep it down, swirl it around like in a circle. Don't take it all the way. See that perforation? Don't take it all the way. Keep it in. See that perforation?
Yeah.
Break it there. Leave the bottom half in. It breaks pretty easy. Yeah. Put the cap back on. Give me this piece.
Yeah.
That's garbage. Okay.
Yeah.
Hold that for a sec.
Yeah. Getting good footage.
So now the bottom of this.
I gotta get it to the sea.
Then we'll show you things that are a little bit different than 3-on-3.
So right side, I'm gonna dribble hard out here.
Conestoga in the building. Got Evan, Ace. Talk to him, Evan. Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah!
Man, read this.
Yo, Noah, what's good, bro? We say fuck.
How you doing? Read this.
Hey guys, just wanted to let you know.
I used to chill with this nigga, man.
I'm not surprised.
No, I'm not either. That's crazy, though.
Yeah. What's up, Mark?
What's up?
Resale.
Hey, I got a new shirt today, you know what I'm saying? Ontario basketball, 1977.
Ready?
Let's just run another one.
I'm not about to play.
Who said you know?
What are you saying, Simon?
This is what I said to Coach. I said, hey, Coach, sorry, I'm on my way.
Come on,
Condor,
come on now.
What's up,
man? I have to do that too, bro.
Ketchup chips.
Come on now.
What's up, Ace? So it's like if you say, yo, you want some ketchup chips to an American, they'll be like, huh?
Yeah.
They'll look at you weird, bro.
This ketchup on chips.
Boy. Yeah, speed up. Don't lose that, though.
Oh,
yeah,
dude.
I don't even know what I'm doing,
bro. That's the remix.
Are you going to be in the NBA one day? What's your name? What?
Freedom.
Freedom.
Good question. Nice shot.
You gonna shout out Hoopin' Brand or what?
Hoopin'.
Yeah.
Good. Look at his face.
Championship game, man. I need a pre-championship game interview. First of all, can you introduce yourself to the audience?
Yo, my name is Connor Weston. You know.
And where are you from?
Well, my boy.
Well, as am I. Okay, let's go. You want to be in my video, sir? Hey, man. You know the freaking vibes, bro. We're in the building. Finally. With my guy Tyler. What's up, Tyler?
Hey.
Tyler McKinney. Instagram?
T McKinney 117.
I'm pretty sure we should have gone up. I'm going back.
You're going back?
Yeah. It's definitely up. Let's go. We're moving on up. Moving on up. Thank you, sir.
Yeah,
oh my goodness. Is this your first time here?
Me?
Yeah.
In the gym, yeah.
Yeah. Are you first here? Whoa.
What, you, sir?
No, first.
Oh, okay.
I'm also first. We're in this together.
Nice.
Yeah, it's beautiful. What sport do you play? What sport do you play?
Basketball.
Oh, basketball, really?
Yeah. I'm you?
Basketball.
You sure?
Push it.
You wanna track that? Like, I don't want that making fun of me when I get in there. Like, I'm pulling that thing.
All right, bro. Emergency exit.
Like, I'm pulling that. Like, that glass. You see the whole thing's moving.
It's locked, yo. Let's go.
Oh, that's the button.
Yeah, you push it from the side.
I'm sweating.
That's so hard. Let's go. Let's go. Yeah, that's Dylan.
Hey, BGT, my boy.
Dude, they don't track me.
I think things will like our offense will look smooth.
at the roundabout, take the second exit onto Ottawa Street South.
Go to lunch in the Jewish community. I won't tell on the bros with immunity. Can't beat them, that shit ain't gonna ruin me. I'm the only one now that I do me. I got hoes by the group trying to do me. My life like a movie, get hit in the water. Yeah, I'm going all in. This vibes, yeah. Hey, I cannot bargain. Come here, talk to y'all. Tell me, bust your dollar. No, y'all, y'all. Fuck out what you want it. Man, there's nothing, mommy. I'm not being funny, y'all. Yeah, I got it, Dylan. Let's go. Send me the Addy, I'm all the doubt. Get off the stage and I jump in the crowd. They can't say I'm too wild. I fell in love with the crowd. I'm with the bees and hits.
What's up, boss?
What's good, man?
Where you said?
You know, I'm getting ready for practice, man.
Getting ready for practice, huh? I saw you were bumping to some music.
Hell yeah, bro.
Hell yeah, bro.
You got it, man. You just got it.
What were you listening to?
I was listening to Lil Baby, man.
Lil Baby? All right, let me know. Lil Baby or Da Baby? Which one you choosing?
Little baby, man.
Little baby. I say less. You heard it here first.
I want to be in there more than you.
Yeah, bro. Are you filming me?
Dave, let me see.
Dame.
Oh, that's sick.
Bullshit is that?
I would love to play.
After this year, fam? Watch.
Yeah, how are they done?
They're indoor with us.
Let's go, Tom. Oh my goodness. That's definitely going in the vlog. All right, Terrell, come on, bro. I need some footage, man. Hey, what's going on, man? Unfortunately, I didn't get that. So you lucked out, Ice. Hey! Come on, Terrell. Let's go, Terrell. Hey. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Yo, Bash, you been tripping on them hoes.
Yeah.
Hey, Miss Donda, you run into my mama, please tell her I said say something. I'm starting to believe ain't no such thing as heaven's trumpets. No after over, this is it done. If there's a heaven, you would think they let you speak to your son. Maybe she has in the form of a baby's laugh I heard passing by in a stroller, reminding me, hey, keep rolling, oh no. Maybe she has with the prick of a blade of grass I've been laying on way too long, got me itchy, got up and roamed a little more. Miss Donda, you see my mama, tell her I'm lost. You see, she'd always light a cigarette, we talk, I would cough, exaggerating a little bit, so she get the point, trying to get her to stop smoking. I would lead and fire up a till I quit, started back up again. 20 years later, all that time, y'all thought were high, thought I was crazy. My mom, she ain't cut no corners, got me back on track. I don't miss her overstepping, but do miss her showing seven civilian life. Miss Donda, you see my mama whisper her this. The real reason I was geeked to go to church, must confess, when y'all grown-ups would be in Bible study, that girl helping me with my homework, her and I were so pure and so spirit spinning and dirty, so on, so on and so on. We hope that no one heard it. And to this day, I think her mama knew, but let us explore. Miss Donda, you see my father, please ask him why. He never married, always smiled, but was he happy inside? Because I carried my mother's name, did he carry shame with him? I'm sure she did it out of spite, was her decision at birth. She probably would hurt. Poor baby, two young people with different views, a lot for a young lady. No coincidence, they both passed away from heart conditions. There's a dissidence at play, dad and mom do hard division. 3,000 poster child for big raised by their mothers. I'm supposed to smile as if God knew that I would be trouble, keeps me around for what I don't know, but I do know that it's crucial that we do so pronto. I don't know how much long though.
Record, I be asking the masses to tune your hearts to me. I represent intelligence that grew up harshly, but lately I've been questioning, second guessing whether or not I've got something to offer inside an eluded poverty, or has the money watered me down? That truth is hard for me, like the second time I got cut from the junior varsity. Fighting back tears, I promised to switch gears and said to myself, whatever you do, you won't do it partially. From this day forward, I move with a new ferocity. Ferrari coupe velocity, a fail-proof philosophy. Success is in the effort, so if it tried as hard as I'm at peace, knowing God ain't dealing in this group of cars for me. Some people say that I'm running third, they threw the bronze at me. Behind Drake and Dot, yeah, them's the superstars to me. Maybe deep down, I'm afraid of my luminosity. So when you see me on red carpets, I'm moving awkwardly. Posing all nervous, afraid of the judgment. And the thought of showing too much of my day is repugnant. I be keeping my kids away from the gaze of the public, cause these days it feel like haters, they favorite subject. Attitude like a young O'Shea with an AK aimed at your brain, violating, I bust it. I don't play when it come to family, that's one thing I refuse. Pimping their kids out for views or just to be in the news can never be me. Pissing a celebrity tea. God with me on this record, this is Heaven's EP. The tale's official, the best reason it just failed to hit you. You couldn't tell cause you failed for the bells and whistles. In that scenario I don't excel. I'm from the Ville where young girls talk grown as hell. It's raw, never saw one person go to Yale, but every that I know done gone to jail at least once. Proving we the ones police hunt for the pains. We smoke 3 blunts the size of tree trunks. Too much hunger, it's no wonder these can't keep up. So saying yes to a feature just means I'm about to eat lunch. I'm going for it, no, never shall he punt. I'm the one and you can be sure, speaking of beachfront. I'm kicking my feet up while I write this in somewhere tropical. Supposed to be relaxing, this passion makes that impossible. Supposed to be relaxing, this passion makes that impossible.
October 14th, woke up this morning, did some mobility, got outside, got some water. Now it's time to go to UOG, get some work in. We have a strength and conditioning thing later today. We have a game tomorrow against Western. Pretty exciting. Let's go do it.
Oh,
4:30 on my way to physio. See this, the old gym right here? All right, I'm late. I gotta go. Yo.
I heard your quiet knocking. What are you
Hi.
Filming?
Yeah.
What?
Making a vlog.
Oh God, I'm in a vlog?
Yeah, yo.
Okay.
How you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good. Hi, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Liv's also gonna be in the vlog? Yeah, what's going on?
Yeah, what's your name?
My name's Liv.
Liv?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
What sport do you play?
Soccer and volleyball.
Two?
Yeah.
Whoa, you're impressive.
Just this year. What is this vlog for?
I'm in public relations.
Okay.
So.
Like a school project?
Yeah. Yeah, you could call it that. That's so dope, man. I really like this. It's beautiful. Yeah, man. Shout out Stacy. Thanks for your time. And now we are on our way to strength and conditioning. I wonder what Jordan has in store for us today. Probably something light, recovery based because of our game tomorrow. But yeah, got some cupping on my shoulders. I need to start working on my posture and continue to stay consistent in terms of improving my imbalances. Whoa, I'm locked out. Yo. How'd you get in there? What the fudge? Where the heck did you come from? Yeah.
I hate y'all. Everybody better show up in 2 minutes because I heard you guys are late on Wednesday.
I'm late.
Oh, shit. I heard you guys are late on Wednesday.
Look at the gym, though. Whoa. Come on, man.
What's up, Terrell?
You got a minute and a half.
Live for the vlog.
What's up, Jordan? What's up?
Get that court in there.
It is raining. Yeehoo! Yeah, yo. This is the workout for today. As you can see here, we got the volleyball team, the basketball team. Bet. Let's go, boy. Here's the truth. I don't think I'm being a good leader when it comes to this team at Conestoga. But I think that's the next step, is to start getting more comfortable with that and start creating real connections. From my own eyes, like, you know, you see that, especially like from childhood trauma or childhood like exclusion, childhood memories. What can I do other than to try and grow? All I can do is try and grow, man. Leadership capable type of thing. But what do I really want to do? I just want to hoop.
Good morning, 6:39 a.m. It's game day. You can see right here, first and foremost, if you can dream it, you can do it. And that the best dreams happen when you're awake. Thank you.
bitch like Mike.
My assistant coach, my trainer. Let me put this on real quick so you know what I'm talking about. You know the vibes. Shout out UVU, shout out Avery. All right, man, let's get it.
You like engaged.
Kind of like indifferent.
Yeah.
Baby, ride me.
Yeah.
She like the way I ride the beat.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. When I was on my way back yesterday, it was pouring, bro.
Yeah.
Say that one more time.
Fucking pro.
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's dope.
Oh, yeah. You know we got the coach.
Good, y'all.
For this? I didn't even know there was one. Yeah, let's go, Dilla.
Let's go, boy.
Yes, sir.
What's going on, vlog?
Yo.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Let's go, coach.
So right here we got the game film going. As you can see, we're just boxing out, playing some defense at this point, trying to get to those closeouts. And this game we ended up losing by a pretty significant amount. It was like 30, 40 points, something like that. Might have even been close to 50, but it definitely showed a lot of weaknesses and areas we need to improve. Right there, we get the help, but as you see, we have a tough time getting the rebounds. Right here, I just am not calm on the catch, so I throw up some crap shot and get a really bad look. Right here, this is post-game film that I got, so these are some of the notes that the coach made, telling us to be more patient on the catch and why dribble when you get that pass. You know, face up and see what the defense is giving you. Right here, I'm putting on some ball pressure, and again, we run into another mistake where we didn't have the rover that helped defender come stop that layup. He didn't come over far enough. Right here, just over dribbling, trying to force too much. Not, you know, just forcing the game, to be honest. But right here, we get a tray ball to fall, and yeah, we get a rebound. And these are some of my highlights that I got. Just shots made and rebounds that I got. We're going to see another tray ball coming up here soon. or that was a two-point shot off the glass right there. And just bringing the ball up the court. We see Elaine take it, get fouled on the play. We move up to get two free throws. So when I got on the court in this game, like, it felt fun, bro. It was like 2 years of COVID not playing the game. So it was just great to be back on the court playing competitively again. Right here, we're looking for our teammate. Don't see nothing, but we see Mark at the top. Ka-ching! Let's go, Mark. That's what I'm talking about. Right here, we take a charge. We got two charges this game, and we probably got about like 12 points, I think, and a handful of rebounds. Get another one right there. Push it up to Terrell. He probably scored that, to be honest. Get another rebound. Looking for our teammates. Don't see nothing, so take it up ourselves until our point guard comes across. Dribble handoff. Get another charge. That's the second of the game right there. Right here, rebound comes to us. We give it to the guard to push up the floor. And then cap it off with another tray ball.
Whenever we at the dinner table, she say she hate that she love me and she wish I was average. Shit, sometimes I wish the same and I wish she wasn't married.
How does it feel to be back home, Dane?
I feel blessed, man.
Feels good?
The opportunity to play, man.
We used to have probably the best basketball team in the country.
Yeah, man. On our way to the Windsor campus, getting off the bus.
Wow.
It was a pretty good drive, 2.5 hours. I forgot my laptop. Let's go, coach. Let's go, Avery. Thank you, sir.
Welcome to Windsor University. I'm about to get deported because I don't have my mask.
Not much to see here.
I don't have a mask either, bro. Shoot.
Man. Yo, get away. 6 feet.
Yo, can we share a mask? What would that look like? Oh my gosh. Get that off of me.
Whoa, that was cool, bro.
Yeah, it's pretty dope, huh? Look at Rylan. Rylan styling.
Hey, yo, we're on Dame's block right now. You know, we in Dame's hood.
Yeah, facts. Any family coming, Dame?
We'll see, man.
We'll see. Rylan, do you know where you're going, bro?
Yeah, go left.
How's it going?
Good.
Good.
Is that a basketball team?
Yeah. Do you play Conestoga?
Conestoga?
Yeah.
I'm from Cambridge.
You're from Cambridge?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. What's your name?
Daniel. I know a lot of guys, but you know Alexander?
No, I'm from Guelph.
Are you from Guelph?
Yeah.
Oh, shoot. Clark's got the angles?
Oh, yeah.
Clark's oh, yeah. Got team photo. Angles. You know the vibes.
So we're back. This game is against Windsor. Right here, you see us D'ing up right here, almost getting a steal. And we're just in it, man. We're playing this game, trying to get a dub. We end up losing this game as well. So we probably lost this game by about 40 or 30, something like that. These university teams are tough, man, for sure. And this team was all rookies. It's like I was the only person who had college experience on this team. So we're a group of young guys. And as you can see, Coach Avery, assistant coach, telling me some stuff right here, trying to mentor me and give me some advice. And I'm just like a sponge, bro, soaking it all in. Step up right there, bang, get that tray ball to fall. And as you can see, they're coming back here, doing their thing, getting rebounds. That's a big, tough thing that we struggled with. And right here, Thomas Kennedy, boom, pins my teammate Dame off the glass. I choose to come up here, shoot it on Tom real quick. Ka-chang, got that tray ball to fall on him. And yeah, he was a tough matchup this game, man, for real. Like, he's played professionally already, has stuff with Canada. Here he faces me up, takes it by, dunks it. And he was a big challenge.
Dylan, what's in the bag, bro? What's in the bag, man?
We got some of the Windsor's official penalty box, you know what I'm saying?
It smells amazing.
Yo, I think that's a mods.
Is it actually excessive?
Yo, what are you doing? I don't like tomatoes, bro. What the fuck?
You can't
just put them on the floor.
Yeah, you can.
Get that on camera.
Food for the ants. Man, bro.
Get him a camera for that.
Yo, you're so thoughtful for feeding the ants.
Yeah, that's what I do. That's what I do.
The ants.
Oh, yeah, eh?
Make sure you grab on that.
No.
Speak up so everybody gets theirs, please.
Yeah.
The day after the Windsor game. Very foggy this morning. I'm not sure if you can tell very well on camera how the eye is looking. I kind of like it. It makes me feel badass. War wounds, I guess you could call it. You know, one of the things I was reflecting on in my journal is just how last game it was reminiscent of, you know, a game I vividly remember against St. James in my 12 plus year. You know, I was catching the ball and shooting these tray balls, and I just didn't understand why these shots weren't going in. Shot, kept shooting, and they weren't dropping. But I am trying to understand what it is. You know, is it the mentality? Is it my shot? But if it is the reason, then, you know, I just gotta adjust. But check this out, man. This is where I come every morning, just right here. And so many times I walk that path. There's a creek right there, some flowing water. And I walk there often, get my mind right, take breaks from school or after a lecture. But I don't have my tripod, but I'm gonna do some movement right now. You know, just some circle hips. Circle those hips around, man. Move my spine around, get some blood flowing. You versus you, man. This is a habit these days. Can you see that? I wonder if you can see the steam. Maybe not. But yeah, man, as I reflect on yesterday's game against Tom, because in the second half I came out and I was saying to the people as I crossed them by, strangers, like, yo, this half is my half. That's what I was saying. I was like, yo, this half is my half. And during the warm-ups, I really just allowed myself to be free. I allowed myself to be that loud, obnoxious kid again that I was at a young age, and I felt so free. It just felt right. The state of mind that I have when I feel like I'm in the flow. Like, I remember I made a lot of journal entries where I said, like youthfulness, just like I did as a kid, because it's not even about necessarily being the best basketball player. I do because that's the game that I want to play. It's just life, man. Sometimes it's not easy, but it would be kind of lame if it was always easy. Look at NBA 2K, for example. You could play on rookie mode, but you're not getting the maximal amount of experience points. You're not getting the most, you know, badge points or VC. But when you play on Hall of Fame, then you get a multiplier, because when it's a bit more challenging, the rewards are more substantial. And, you know, that's pretty symbolic of life, too. The comfort zone, you already know the comfort zone. But there's this element where it's like, when I start playing other guys, specifically like Tom, a big dude, you know, dudes who, like, I kind of view as, you kind of made it, didn't you? Like, just, they're at a higher level. They're already playing pro. They're already 6'8", and they're 240 pounds. And so I think that there has to be something that I have to journal and constantly speak as in, like, an affirmation to shift my mindset to not view these people as superior, because as a result that makes me feel inferior, and I've become aware that drops my level of play. Look at this view, man. Sun's coming up.
Good morning.
That's an interesting photo.
Yeah, looks nice, eh?
Are you just waiting for the sun to come up over the trees?
Yeah. Have a great walk.
Yeah, you too. Have a good day.
Thank you. Anyways, man, I'm gonna figure this out, bro. A couple years ago, I'm too afraid to post this. Why? It's life. You only live once. On the bus yesterday, Avery was talking about that, you know, how you look back and you be like, what if I did this? What if I could have done that? Nah, why don't you just do what you gotta do in the present? And that's what I'd like to do. I wanna try for myself, even if it's just a legacy for my kids. And that's really how this all started, is I started journaling during lockdown. I started journaling as if it was to write to my future kids just lessons, little nuggets of wisdom. And I'm kind of approaching this as the same thing. If I have some kids one day, I want them to see who their father was, what type of person he was, and so they can look and they can be better than me. Almost half an hour, I'm just standing here talking, bro. Beep test today. Last time I ran a beep test, man, middle school maybe. It's been a while. We'll see how it goes. And then we have practice. And I didn't bring my laptop. Nice. Hey!
Going to the left first.
You're not doing this anymore.
When you're ready.
Go, Ben. Come on, Ben.
Yeah, Ben.
Right through. When you're ready.
Right through.
Yeah. Right through, finish.
Yeah.
Next up, Ben. When you're ready. If you miss the beat twice, we're pulling you up. Or if you just finish off on your own. Ready?
The 20 meter bleep test starts in 10 seconds. Level 1 starts with a triple bleep after a 5 second countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So that was the beep test, 18.9. I remember when I was in middle school, man, struggle on that, like seven, eight, nine. When I got 10, I remember when I got 10, I was pretty happy. On the sprint, I got 2.99. Who got the highest on the beep test? I think it was Evan. He got 20? I think he got 20. Next time I'm getting 20.
What did you say?
tripping, I'm tripping off the powder. Shit's alright. Rules closed, the wrist is open. We ain't got nothing to lose, mom. We roll. We roll. There's some nice skinned girls, there's some pretty rollers.
Against Waterloo, I couldn't get the footage, so it's only a couple of clips right here. First, Marcus the block. Next clip, they pass to me at the top. I get a tray ball to fall on his head. Bang! And then I think there's a steal that comes after this. Oh no, my guy Terrell gets a 3-point off my screen. Bang! And I'm pretty sure we ended up losing this game too, unfortunately.
Post-practice vibes. About to get the bags.
You guys aren't getting your shit. Oh! God damn it! That's a wood block
right there. You know, you think they'd spell your name right. Coach, there you go.
Yeah. Coach, get it back. Where better go? Where better go?
Where better go? Where better go?
Yeah! Rocky.
Clark's not here.
Clark, get the fuck in back!
Me and Simon will shoot for it.
Yeah!
Clark,
yeah.
What's in the bag, bro?
Man.
Show me the gear.
Condo, all right. Man.
All right.
Eh?
Cool down.